Hello, and welcome to this Hurricane Electric presentation about our free IPv6 tunnelbroker.net system. Tunnelbroker.net provides IPv6 tunnels to those who cannot get native IPv6 connectivity. We provide two types of tunnels in this system: a regular IPv6 tunnel for workstations or co-located equipment, as well as Bgp tunnels for networks that want to announce their own IPv6 net blocks and can't because they don't have native IPv6. We've made a couple web interface changes. Recently, we've deployed an IPv6 certification program. On our website, we list two of the statistics out of this program. We have the top 10 scoring individuals, where the score is based on completion of certification level exams, and the score can also be incremented from daily tests. We also list the latest 10 certs given out to 10 users and what that recent cert level is. We now also provide an IPv4 exhaustion counter, which can be found at ipv6.each.net/statistics. On that page, we have an iPhone application, an Android application, a web page widget, an iGoogle gadget, a Google desktop gadget, and a Windows Vista and 7 desktop gadget. We also now have forums available for our users registered either through tunnelbroker.net or the IPv6 certification program. Registration means that you can post comments or questions. We also present usage statistics for both the tunnelbroker.net system as well as the IPv6 certification program. So let's go ahead and create ourselves a tunnel. So we'll log in. Now a couple more changes have happened. We now allow multiple tunnels under a single account, up to a total number of 4 tunnels. We used to only allow 1 tunnel per account. So if you've got a couple of old accounts with single tunnels, you can log in as those accounts, go to the tunnels detail page, and there you're going to find what we call a claim code. In this example, I've already claimed this tunnel, but at the top, instead of the word claimed, there'll be a unique code for that tunnel. You'll copy down that code, log out, and log back into the new master account you want to have handle all of your tunnels. You'll click the Combine Tunnels function. Here you'll paste in that code from that tunnel, click Submit, and we'll reallocate that tunnel to your new account and close out the old account. If you want to create a BGP tunnel, you simply provide us your ASN, the IPv4 endpoint for your BGP speaking router, and what IPv6 net blocks you wish to announce through us. Then you can also pick which location is closest to you and hit submit. This is a manual tunnel, which means that we need to approve and verify the ASN and IPv6 net block information before we create the tunnel and BGP session. Once approved and created on our side, we'll email you letting you know that it's set up on our side and you can turn up yours whenever you like. If you simply need a regular tunnel, you'll click Create Regular Tunnel, and we've made a couple extra features on this page. We try and determine, based on your workstation that you're browsing the site from, what IPv4 endpoint you're coming in from. We also try and automatically recommend the closest tunnel server based off that IP. If you're not trying to turn it up on your workstation, and instead perhaps a remote box in colocation, you can simply input that IPv4 endpoint for that server, and you can click Override, so you can go ahead and pick whichever location is closest to your colocated equipment. In this case, I want to use tunnel on my workstation. So I'll go ahead and copy the IP, paste it in. I'm in Fremont, so I want to remain selecting the Fremont tunnel server, and I'll click Submit. This will take a few moments while we try and ping the remote IPv4 endpoint to make sure that we can reach it. Once verified, we'll go ahead and create the tunnel on our side. Once created, you'll come to this page that says, okay, your tunnel's been allocated. So now you need the tunnel details. So you click the link for tunnel details. On the tunnel details page, we have a description field in case you actually do have multiple tunnels, one for work, one for home, maybe one on a laptop where you'll keep updating the IPv4 endpoint. In the description field, you can input what that description is going to be for the tunnel so you can keep track of them easier. On the page, we provide the server IPv4 and IPv6 addresses, as well as the IPv4 endpoint that you inputted, and what your side of the tunnel's /64 allocation will be. If at any time you need to update your IPv4 endpoint, you can log into the system, click on that particular tunnel's details, and your IP is a link to a page for updating your IPv4 endpoint. If your IPv4 endpoint constantly changes, we have a URL that you can script against, and the link is on this update IPv4 endpoint page. Clicking it will take you to the URL, which will show you the usage. We also provide an anycasted IPv6 and IPv4 caching name server. This is part of the Google whitelisted DNS project, so you can access Google directly over IPv6 without having to input into a web browser ipv6.google.com. By default, we statically route you a single /64 through your side of the tunnel. If you require additional subnets, you can click on the Allocate button from Routed 48, and this will allocate you a /48, which is 65,536 /64s. To delegate reverse DNS to name servers of your choosing, so you can customize the reverse DNS, by default, there are none set up, so you can click any of these name server links, and you can input up to 3 name servers with their fully qualified domain name, not IP address, for us to delegate reverse DNS to. A note that this is only for your routed prefixes, the statically routed 64 or 48 allocation. This will not change the reverse DNS for your tunnel's point-to-point /64 allocation. We also provide example OS configurations as well as router platforms, Cisco, Juniper, and Juniper's NetScreen. In this case, my workstation is Ubuntu 9.04, so I like using the Linux IP route 2 commands. So I'll pick them, click Show Config, the page will regenerate with those example commands. Now, as I'm using Ubuntu 9.04, IPv6 is no longer a kernel module loaded outside of the kernel, but is now compiled into it. So I no longer need to mod probe for the IPv6 module. Now, I've given IP commands for turning up the tunnel on my workstation. However, my workstation does not operate on my IPv4 endpoint. In fact, that is a NAT appliance. So what I need to do is go to my system and find out what IP I'm actually using locally. Here, we can see that IP is 10.255.45.138. So I'm going to copy all these commands. I'm going to go to a text editor, put them in, remove what was set as my IPv4 endpoint, put in my actual local address, and now the commands are complete. So I'll go ahead and take my commands. On the command line, I'm going to become the super user. I'm going to go ahead and paste in those commands. I'm going to verify that the tunnel interface has been created. We see that it has. So I'm going to go ahead and use ping 6 against an IPv6 hostname. And we can see that behind NAT, I've got my IPv6 connectivity, and everything's working. If you have any questions about the TunnelBroker.net service, please feel free to contact us. at IPv6 at he.net.